Good morning, students. I hope you all are well at home. So, today we will discuss about our next chapter of math, that is 12th chapter, Ratio, Proportion and Unitary Methods. So, let's start our chapter. We often come across situations where we need to compare two quantities in terms of their magnitude. Suppose you have one bottle of cold drink and your brother have also one bottle of cold drink. So in your bottle the cold drink is half, and in your brother's bottle cold drink is much larger than your bottle. That means how can you when we see that both the bottles it look like same, but when we measure the quantities it is greater. So how can we measure it? That means we have to need to compare the quantities in term of their magnitude. So let's compare ages of Ali and Gurpreet, who are 12 and 10 year old. This comparison could be done in two ways. First one is comparison by difference. That means the difference in their ages is 2 years. So how can we find the how can we compare the difference? That means we have to subtract 12 minus 10. It is 2 years. Hence we say Ali is 2 years older than to Gurpreet. Now moving to next comparison by division. We have two types of comparison. First one is difference and second one is division. So Ali's age divided by Gurpreet's age, that means 12 divided by 10, it becomes 6/5. How can it become 6/5? Because both the numbers are divisible by 6. That means 2, 6 2's are 12 and 5 2's are 10. That is, Ali's age is equal to 6/5 times Gurpreet's age. This comparison by division is called ratio, and ratio is denoted by symbol this. In the above example, ratio of Ali's age to Gurpreet's age is 6/5. So moving to first, that is ratio. The ratio of two quantities of same kind and expressed in same units is a fraction that shows how many times one quantity is of the other. That means it look like same as a fraction, but in a ratio we can expressed in the same units is fraction. That shows how many times one quantity of the other. That means which quantity is more than other quantity. So the ratio of any two non-zero numbers A and B is A divided by B. That means A by B. Symbolically, ratio between two numbers is denoted by A ratio B. So the number A and B are called the terms of ratio A ratio B. The first term A is antecedent and second term B is consequent. So the first point is the ratio A ratio B and B ratio A are not equal. They are equal only if A is equal to B. Let's take an example. Suppose we have value of A is equal to 5 and B is equal to 6. And firstly, we write it A ratio B. That means 5 ratio 6, 5 divided by 6. In second, we have B ratio A. Put the value of B ratio A, 6 ratio 5. That means it is 6/5. That means 5 by 6 not equal to 6/5. Because here numerators and denominators are different. But only in one situation A ratio B is equal to B ratio A. If both the values of A and B are equal, suppose A is equal to 1 and B also is equal to 1. That means 1 ratio 1 is equal to 1 ratio 1. So in this case, we can say A ratio B is equal to B ratio A if both the values of A and B are equal. So now next is the ratio A ratio B has no units. It is independent of units of A and B. third point is the ratio A and B is defined only if A and B are non-zero numbers. That means not equal to zero. These are non-zero numbers. And next one is ratio can be expressed as a fraction. Expressed as a fraction, that means 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 5 by 6 and other types. So next one is simplest form of ratio. Moving to next, that is simplest form of ratio. A ratio is in its simplest form if the terms of ratio have no common factors other than 1. For example, the simplest form of ratio 20 ratio 15 is 4 ratio 3. That means there is a no common factor because 3 and 4 are not divisible by to each other's table. That means the common factor is only 1. So it is a simplest form of ratio. Next one is equivalent ratio. Equivalent ratio, that means both the ratios are, value of both the ratios are equal. Multiplying or dividing the first and second term of ratio by the second non-zero number gives equivalent ratio. That means firstly we have to find the LCM of the both the denominators, then we can convert the denominators into same number. So when we find the equivalent ratio, consider ratio 8 ratio 6. We have 8 ratio 6. Firstly, we divide both the numbers by 2. Why we divide both the numbers by 2? Because we know that if the ones place number is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, it is divisible by 2. So here both the numbers are 8 and 6. That means both the numbers are divisible by 2. So when we divide 8 by 2, it becomes 4, and 2 by 6, it becomes 3. Also, 8 by 6 is equal to 8 by 6 when we multiply both the numbers by same number, that is 3, 8 3 is a 24 and 6 3 is a 18. So when we cut 24 by 18, again in ones place number is 4 and 8, it is also divisible by 2. That means 12 2 is a 24 and 9 2 is a 18. Now ones place number is 2, but here 9, it not comes upon the table of 2. So moving to next number is 3. That means 4 3 is a 12 and 3 3 is a 9. Now the answer of when we divide the number by 2 and when we multiply both the numbers by 3, answer is remaining same. Therefore 4 ratio 3 and 24 ratio 8 are equivalent ratio of 8 ratio 6. In this way we can find the equivalent ratios. Next one is dividing a number in the given ratio. If number P is divided in the ratio A ratio B, then first part is equal to A divided by A plus B, bracket round bracket close, multiply with P, and the second part write B firstly divided by A plus B, round bracket close, and multiply with P. For example, let's divide 35 in ratio 2 ratio 3. That means how can we find the divide 35 ratio 2 ratio 3? Firstly, we write 2 in the place of A and then adding both the ratio numbers 2 multiply 3 and multiply with 35. That means 2 by 5 multiply 35, it becomes 14. And when second part, write 3 upon 2 plus 3 multiply 35, it is 21. So in this way we can dividing a number in the given ratio. So now moving to next topic, that is comparison of ratios. To compare two or more ratios, we first convert them into fractions and then follow this method learned in the chapter on fractions. So moving to first example, there are 20 girls and 25 boys in a class. So first question is, what is the ratio of numbers of girl in the number of boys? So how can we find ratio of number of girls to the ratio of number of boys? That means 20 ratio 25. Why we write 20 firstly? Because we find the ratio of number of girls to the number of boys. That's why we have writing 20 firstly. That means A, value of A is 20 and value of B is 25. It is 4 by 5. How can we say it is 4 by 5? Divide 20 by 25. both the numbers are divisible by 5 because in ones place number is 0 and 5. So 4 5s are 20 and 5 5s are 25. So moving to next, what is the ratio of number of girls to the total number of students in the class? So firstly, we have to find the total number of students in the class. That means 20 plus 25. It is equal to 45. So ratio of number of girls to the total number of students in the class, that means 20 ratio 20 plus 25, 20 ratio 45. So again we divide 20 by 45, that means again it is divisible by 5, 5 4s are 20 and 9 5s are 45. So ratio is 4, 9, 5. So now moving to next, out of 40 students in a class, 9 like football, 15 like cricket and the remaining like tennis. Find the ratio of number of students liking cricket to the number of students liking tennis. Firstly, we write the total number of students in class 40, and we find the students liking cricket and number of students liking tennis. That means number of students who like tennis, firstly 40 minus 9 plus 15, because 9 students like football and 15 like cricket and the remaining like tennis. That's why we have subtracted 9 plus 15 minus 40, that means it becomes 16 students like tennis. Now we find the number of students liking cricket to tennis and cricket like 15 ratio 16. So next one is number of students liking cricket to the total number of students. How many students like cricket? That means 15, and total number of students is 40. So it becomes 15 ratio 40. So it is 3 ratio 8. Now moving to next example. For the given figure, determine the ratio of number of triangles to the number of squares inside the rectangle. We have given a rectangle. In a rectangle, we have given the number of triangles and number of squares and number of circles also. So firstly, we find the number of triangles to the number of squares inside the rectangle. Firstly, how many triangles we have? This first one, two, three, and also this one, four. And next one is number of squares. How many squares we have? One and two. Now number of triangles inside the rectangle 4 and number of square inside the rectangle is equal to 2. So number of circle inside the rectangle is equal to 1, 2, and 3. So total number of figure inside in the rectangle 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Total number of figures inside the rectangle. Firstly, we find the ratio of number of triangles to the square. That means 4 ratio 2. It becomes 2 ratio 1. So moving to next, that is number of squares to the number of circle inside the rectangle. Number of squares are 2 and number of circles are 3. That means we find the number of squares to the number of circle inside the rectangle. That means 2 ratio 3. So third part is number of circles to all the figure inside the rectangle. Total number of figures are 9 and number of circles are 3. So firstly we write number of circles inside the figure is equal to 3 and total number of figures inside the rectangle is equal to 9. Now we find the ratio of circles to ratio of figures. That means 3 ratio 9. So it is 3 ratio 9. 3 ones are 3 and 3 threes are 9. So it becomes 1 ratio 3. So moving to next question. Next question is the distance traveled by Roy and Akhtar in an hour is 8 km and 6 km. Find the ratio of speed of Roy to the speed of Akhtar. So that means speed of Roy 8 km per hour and speed of Akhtar is 6 km per hour. So ratio of speed of Roy to speed of Akhtar is 8:6. That means 4:3. In this way, we can find the any ratios of any numbers. So moving to next example. Out of 2,000 students in a school, 750 opted for basketball, 800 opted for cricket, and the remaining opted for table tennis. If a student can opt for only one game, find the ratio of number of students who opted for basketball to those who opted for table tennis. That means, firstly, total number of students 2000, because we have given out of 2000 students, number of students who opted for table tennis. Firstly, we have to subtract 750 plus 800, total of 800 plus 750 from 2000. Then we are able to find the number of students who like table tennis. It is 450. So number of students who opted for basketball to number of students who opted for table tennis, that means 750:450. It is 5:3. Similar next parts we have like that way. Moving to next question. Consider the statement, the ratio of breadth and length of a hall is 3:5. Complete the given table that shows some possible breadths and lengths of the hall. So we have given breadths of a hall in meter, that is 15, 45. Next one is 25, 50, and we have to find the length and also breadth of the hall. So the ratio of breadth and length of the hall is 3:5. How can we say it is 3:5? Because firstly, 15 ones are 15, 15 twos are 30, and 15 threes are 45. That means we have to multiply, we have to write the first three multiples of 15. Next 25 ones are 25, 25 twos are 50. That means here also we write the first three multiples of 25. That means both the numbers are same multiples. So because we have to multiply 15 with 1, similar 15 with 2, and similar 15 with 3. In next we have to multiply 25 with 1, 25 with 2, and 25 with 3, it becomes 75. The ratio of breadth and length of a hall is 3:5. Moving to next, divide 36 copies between Vineet and Neelu in the ratio of 4:5. The sum of two parts of ratio is equal to 4 + 5 = 9. It implies that out of 9 copies, Vineet will get 4 and Neelu will get 5. Therefore, number of copies Vineet gets 4/9 multiplied 36 is equal to 16. And the number of copies Neelu gets 5/9 multiplied 36 is equal to 20. 9 fours are 36 and 5 fours are 20. So moving to next question, the present age of Priya is 12 years. The age of Priya's father is 42 years. Priya's mother age is 6 years younger to her father. Find the ratio of present age of Priya to her mother's age. So firstly, we write the present age of Priya is 12 years. Present age of Priya's father is 42 years. And present age of Priya's mother is 42 minus 6. Why we subtract? Because Priya's mother is 6 years younger to her father. That's why we have to subtract 42 minus 6. It is 36 years. So first part is present age of Priya to her mother's age. Firstly, we find the present age of Priya to her mother's age. So that means present age of Priya's mother is 36 and present age of Priya is 12. So first part is present age of Priya is equal to 12 years and mother's age is equal to 36 years. So ratio of present age of Priya to her mother, that means 12:36. It is 12 ones are 12, 12 threes are 36, 1:3. So first part is done. And moving to second part, present age of Priya's father to Priya's mother. That means Priya's father's age is 42 and Priya's mother's age is 36. Father age ratio mother's age. 42 ratio 36. Now again, 7 6 are 42 and 6 6 are 36. Moving to third part. Third one is age of Priya to her mother when Priya age was 10 years. So that means age of Priya's mother when Priya's age was 10 years. So age of mother when Priya's age was 10 years. That means 2 years less than from present age. So that's why we have to subtract her mother's age 2 years from present age minus 2. It becomes 34 years. Now required ratio is equal to 10 ratio 34. It is 5 twos are 10 and 17 twos are 34. It is the answer. So moving to next part, age of Priya's father to age of her mother 10 years ago. That means age or her 10 years ago, 32 ratio 26. So it is 16 ratio 3. In this way, we can find the ratio of any numbers.